People want me to do everything for them, and what they don't realize is they have the power. You want to see a miracle, son? Be the miracle.
So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can take poor sounding audio like this and transform it into this, which is more high quality and more professional, just with a few clicks of a button. Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome back to Gal. In this video, I'm super excited to share with you this awesome tool that helps you mix sound fast and is called Alex Audio Butler. Essentially, it's a robot that was built by this company, Unimule, that basically will make your sound sound awesome, whether you're dealing with sound effects, music, and dialogue all together. It does it for you. Now, I've shown you guys how to use the Essential Sound Panel to level out dialogue, sound effects, and music, but this is so much faster. Like, literally, I was skeptical at first. I was like, well, we already have the Essential Sound Panel and it does a pretty good job. Why would I need a paid for plugin to do this? Well, literally, I tried it out and my audio sounds so much better. You don't even have to know what EQ is. You don't have to deal with volume. It takes care of it for you. It's amazing. And basically, I'm just gonna demo how easy it is to use and a couple different things that you can change using two different sequences inside of Premiere Pro. So let's go ahead and jump on in. For this first sequence that is called Himalayas here, I've put together some stock video shots from Envato Elements and some music and sound effects. Now let me play back and you can hear that the wind and the music is just way too loud and you can barely hear my narration. It's really difficult to hear my voice, the wind is too loud, the music is too loud. Now, you can use Premiere Pro's built-in Essential Sound Panel, which allows you to correct each different sound clip and move some sliders, but with Audio Butler, you can have it all magically be corrected and mixed for you just with a couple clicks. And this is how you install it. Before you go ahead and open up the audio track mixer, which is what you use to use Audio Butler, you need to first go up to Premiere Pro, Preferences, Audio, and from here, just click on Audio Plugin Manager and click on Scan for Plugins. You just wanna make sure that Alex Audio Butler is checked so that way it's working and then hit OK and OK. Now from the audio track mixer, if you do not see this, just make sure you're in the audio workspace. So from here, you can see that each track here, audio track one, has my voice tracks on it. Audio track two, I have the wind. And audio track three, I have the music. So from the audio track mixer, you can see audio one here. We can also name this to voice just to make it easier. From up here, you're just going to select the effects dropdown and select VST3, tools, Unimule, and select voice, Audio Butler. And now for audio track two, which is our sound effects, we can label that as SFX. And up here, we're going to select VST3, tools, Unimule, and sound effects. And from audio track three, we're going to select VST3, tools, Unimule, and music. And then from the master, we're going to select VST3, tools, Unimule, and master. And so now all of the effects are applied and you'll see this little robot status here. And generally it works better if you play it through. So that way Alex Audio Butler can start to analyze the sound and start to make automatic adjustments for you. So let's go ahead and play it through.
There are only 14 peaks in the world that rise to over 8,000 meters. All of them are here in the Himalayas.
So you can already hear it sounds so much better, and you can see that it finished the analysis just a minute ago. Now, what's really amazing about this is that you can click on any of these effects for voice, double click, and you can choose different types of auto volume and compressions. If you want it to be maximum, it can be very loud and sound harsh, but it depends on what you're going for. You can go with general, And let's just keep it at that. And then for sound effects, you can choose different levels of volume, and it defaults to 3, and it auto ducking is off. What we can do is have the sound effects subtly duck when the voice is there. So I'm going to select subtle. And then for the music, you can choose to have auto ducking be medium or subtle as well. I'm going to choose subtle. There's also contrasting, which makes it even more obvious that the music is ducking behind the voice. So let's go ahead and choose subtle. And then for the master, this is where you can actually control the overall compression and the export target. So if this is a digital media for online, you can choose online, but if it's for television or radio, you can choose broadcast, and you can choose to boost the compression, which will bring the loud and the soft parts closer together, or maximum, which is the full compression for maximum loudness, but can be harsh when input material contains background noise. So if we wanted to choose max in this case, then we can go ahead and play it through, and Alex Audio Butler will automatically make the changes.
There are only 14 peaks in the world that rise to over 8,000 meters. All of them are here in the Himalayas.
That is how you use it with this sequence. I have another sequence here. This is an intro sequence from my last video on how to create 3D portraits in After Effects, which involves voice and sound effects and music. So let me just play this back, and you can hear that it's really difficult to hear my voice.
Hey, what's up, you guys? And welcome back to Gal.
So you can kind of hear the sound effects and kind of hear my voice, but the music is too loud. So this is where we're going to use Audio Butler to do this. So once again, from Audio Track Mixer, if you do not see the effects on the left, click on this arrow and it will open up the effects. Then from here, we have our voice on Audio Track 1. Make sure that all of your voice tracks are on Audio Track 1. Then select VST 3, Tools, Unimule, Voice. And we actually have sound effects on audio layer 2 and 3. So we're going to apply the sound effects Audio Butler to both audio track 2 and 3. And then for audio track 4, we have our music. So let's go ahead and apply Audio Butler music. And then we don't have anything on audio track 4 and 5. We're actually just going to apply the master to the master track, Alex Master Audio Butler. And then what's going to happen is generally you want to play it through so that way Audio Butler can read and understand the audio, and then it begins to make adjustments. So you can see the analysis that's occurring from this little robot pop-up. And let's play it back.
Hey, what's up, you guys, and welcome back to Gal. In this video, I'm showing you how you can take a 2D photo and transform it into a 3D moving image that you guys saw in the opening. Now, to create this effect, you need to use.
And just like that, you can magically sound mix your next video without having any knowledge of EQ, compression, or decibels.
I mean, come on, BBC, Planet Earth, you can hire me now, because I can just record from home and Alex Butler can make it sound great and it's good to go. I mean, all I can say is this is going to be a game changer for a lot of editors. I'm not saying that sound mixers, their role is not important. Their craft is amazing, and I think that you definitely need to have somebody there that has an ear to the ground. But if you just need to finish your video, sound mix it, make it sound great, and really impress your audience and your clients, use this tool. It's 100% worth the money to buy to improve your sound and save you tons of time. So let me know what you guys think of Alex Audio Butler. If you think it's awesome like I do, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. And let me know if you guys have any questions. That's all for this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.